It's February 2010. Chelsea against Cardiff in the FA Cup fifth round brings together two of the most feared hooligan firms in the UK, the Chelsea Headhunters and Cardiff's Soul Crew, who square up not far from Stamford Bridge.
First of all, you're not just talking about Chelsea and Cardiff, you're talking about England and Wales. It's a Category C game, so I've been told afterwards, which is the most volatile game that there is. Now, they want to let 6,000 Cardiff supporters out at the same time as Chelsea. I mean, come on, you know, I mean, I thought the police were there to police. Everyone knows that there was disturbances, and the police, I would imagine, had been working on that since the day the draw had come out.
The violent reputation of the Headhunters grew in the 80s and 90s, and Jason Marriner was one of their main faces.
It's a massive addiction. Listen, it's a disease. Listen, I'm 43 years old. I've been going to football since I was, you know, I couldn't tell you. You know, people remember their first game. Well, I'm sorry, I can't remember my first game. That's how long I've been going. It's been happening, sorry, since I've been going. I remember Maggie Thatcher saying, it's a disease, we've got to get rid of this disease, let's stamp it out. It's, you know, it's like a cancer. Boom, 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 this, that and the other. Well, this cancer ain't gone. It's just spread, and it's spread to a younger generation. Now, I mean, obviously a lot of people have been to prison for football and things like that, and, you know, your football mates are the ones that stick by you, you know, because they're living and breathing it, and, you know, week in and week out. Don't forget, I've got 6 years for football violence, for alleged football violence, should I say, right? And let me tell you, I was in prison with rapists that got done lesser sentences. Tell me whether that's shocking or not. And I'm there and I'm prepared to help the younger generation not go to prison.
After decades of hardcore football violence, the Headhunters earned a cult status within this underground world. They effectively became a global brand.
Headhunters has gone worldwide. You know, I was talking to someone earlier and they said, you know, obviously we have a, you know, we've got the thing with Lazio. You know, someone was over and they brought out the big Chelsea banner with Lazio. And obviously we've always had the Blues Brothers, the affiliation with Glasgow Rangers. And then there's a little affiliation with Feyenord, and then boom, boom, you know, and it knocks on. And whether that's because people just like the name or like the sound or whatever, but they get on it and they, you know, to be honest, in the Aces, it wouldn't have been accepted. You know, they would have come over and it would not have been accepted because at them days, it was very tight-knit. It was a lot more stronger. A lot of the foreign firms have followed the English. Because, you know, I'm not saying it's anything to be proud of, but English, you know, they did sort of generate the football violence, you know. I mean, as far as I'm concerned, you know, the 80s was a whole different ballgame. Obviously, it was a different era, so that tells you, you know, people do move with the times. Football's moved on with the times. Terraces has moved on with the times. If I'm being really honest with you, I mean, West Ham were good. Whether you like to say that or not, in the 80s, West Ham were good. But West Ham were good because of their organisation. You know, Chelsea, Millwall, you know, to be honest with you, they've both got notorious names. I think them two coming up in a draw says it all. Chelsea, Millwall, Millwall, Chelsea. However you want to put it, it don't go away. It's still got two notorious names with it. Now, you know, I'm sure when it comes out, the other, you know, the old Bill go, God, fuck, mate, we don't need this, you know what I mean? As far as I'm concerned, and I can't stress this enough, they're always going to be there. They're always, always going to be there. Going back in the day, you know, Tottenham always, always, you know, they don't like us, we don't like them. That's the bottom line. You know, there ain't no getting through it. You know, it's as simple as that.
We hate Tottenham! We hate Tottenham!
Something that your wife, your girlfriend, could never understand. So, you know, not that you want to, because what do you want to talk to your old woman about football for? But, you know, that's what you're there for. You talk to your mates 24/7 about it and they fully understand.